Manjunath P, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science. So this subject is called as Undead Programming. This subject is belongs to BSc Computer Science 5th semester. This subject is as per the Gulbarga University, Kalaburgi. So in this session we are discuss about the introduction to Undead Programming and history of Undead. So this subject objective is the So you have to study about the application programming concept of the Undead. In this session, we will discuss about the introduction of an Undead programming, history of an Undead programming, the features of an Undead programming. And next, Undead interface, Undead hardware. And next one is application of Undead the programming. Next, advantages and disadvantages of an Undead the programming. So in this session we are discussing about one of the concepts. Next, you have to go to the introduction of an Undead the programming. Undead is an open source operating system based on Linux with a Java programming interface for mobile devices such as smartphones as well as for the tablets. So Undead amadu enanthare ond open source operating system ide. It is based on the Linux with the Java the programming interface. So for the mobile devices mobile devices use martive matha tablets use now Undead programming on the Undead the program software the operating system now use martive. Undead was developed by Open Handset Alliance, so which is led by the Google. So Undead yara develop madare it can be developed by the Open Handset Alliance, so which is led by the Google. The Open Handset Alliance is a consortium of multiple companies like Samsung, Sony, Intel and many more to provide the services and deploy handset using the Undead the platform. The Open Alliance and Handset Alliance is of the multiple companies. Usually multiple companies are not aware of the Samsung, Sony, Intel, many more to provide the service and deploy the using the Undead platform. So initially Undead. So it is also called as the one of the Undead was founded by the Palo Alto, California in October 2003 by Andy Rubin, Rich Miner, Nick Says and Chris White. So these are the one of the developers. Google brought Undead encryption on August 17th, 2005 for at least one of the $15 million. So ಈ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಶಿಯಲಿ ಯಾರು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಸೊ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫೌಂಡರ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಲೋ ಆಲ್ಟೋ ಕ್ಯಾಲಿಫೋರ್ನಿಯಾ ಇನ್ October 2003 ಬೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡಿ ರುಬಿನ್, ರಿಚ್ ಮೈನರ್, ನಿಕ್ ಸಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ ವೈಟ್. ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಇನ್ಶಿಯಲಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ ಆನ್ August 17, 2005 ಫಾರ್ ದ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ $50 million ಈ ಒಂದು ಅವರು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರು ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ರಾಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದರು ಯಾರು ನಮ್ಮ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಅವರು. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಫೋನ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಿ STC ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಟಿ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ G1. ಫಸ್ಟು ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಫೋನ್ ಯಾವುದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದರೆ STC ಡ್ರೀಮ್ ಟಿ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ G1 ಅನೌನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ 23rd September 2008, ರಿಲೀಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ October 22, 2008. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅನೌನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ 23rd September 2008 ಆಯಿತು, ಬಟ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂದರೆ October 22, 2008 ಅದು ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಯಿತು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಇನ್ 2010 ಗೂಗಲ್ ವಿತ್ STC ಲಾಂಚ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ಗೂಗಲ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಂತಂದರೆ 2010 ಒಂದು STC ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡಿತ್ತು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಸರು ಕೂಡ ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಂತ ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಹೆಸರನ್ನ ಅವರು ಯಾರು ಗೂಗಲ್ ಅವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಗೂಗಲ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಫೋನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ದೇರ್ ಫ್ಲಾಗ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ಮತ್ತು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಂದರೆ ಕ್ಯಾಮ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಫೋನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ದೇರ್ ದ ಫ್ಲಾಗ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ನೋಡೋದಾದರೆ ಇನ್ಶಿಯಲಿ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆನ್ November 5, 2007. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಶಿಯಲಿ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಏನು ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಯಾವಾಗಂದರೆ November 5, 2007. From that onwards, Google releases a lot of Android versions under the code name based on the desserts such as the apple pie, banana bread, cupcake, donut, eclair, proyo, ginger bread, jelly beans, kitkat, lollipop, Marsho, Mallo, etc. These are one of the Google campaigns as the various type of the versions. In 2007, Google released the first beta version of the Android software development kit. This is also called the SDK, and the first commercial version of the Android 1.0 with the name is called as Alpha was released in September 2008. So, in 2018, Google released the first version of the Android software kit. Development kit now release madru aa ondu thing the first commercial version of the Android 1.0 anu karadru so adakke ond hesaru kotta irantare alpha so idu yavaga andre September 2008 alli adu release madaru in 2012 Google releases another version of the Android 4.1 Jelly Bean its incremental update and its improved lot of terms of their user interface functionality and performance in 2012 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅನದರ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ 4.1 ಜೆಲ್ಲಿ ಬೀನ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಇದೇ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಕ್ರಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಅಪ್ಡೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಡ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂಸರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಾಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ 2014 ಗೂಗಲ್ ಅನೌನ್ಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ 5.0 ಲಾಲಿಪಾಪ್ ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಲಾಲಿಪಾಪ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೂಗಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ರೀನ್ಯೂಡ್ ದ ಯು ಐ ಅಂದರೆ ಯೂಸರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ಸ್ which is good for the user interface as well as the one of the themes related ಈ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷನ್ ಅವರು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಒಂದು ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ವರ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ವರ್ಷನ್ ಏನು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ September 23, 2008 ದ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 1.0 ದ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ 1 ದ ವರ್ಷನ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಪಲ್ ಪೈ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ 1.0 ಸೊ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಆ್ಯಪಲ್ ಪೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ February 9, 2009 ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 1.1 ದ ಆ್ಯಪ್ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಈಸ್ 2 ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಬನಾನಾ ದ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಷನ್ ನೇಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದಿ April 30, 2009 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 1.5 ದ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ 3 ಅಗೇನ್ ವರ್ಷನ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಕಪ್ ಕೇಕ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ September 15, 2009 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 1.6 ದ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ 4 ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಷನ್ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ October 26, 2009 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 2.0 to 2.1 ದ API 5 to 7 ದ ನೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಇ ಎಸ್ಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ May 20, 2010 ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ 2.2 to 2.23 ದ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ 8 ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಯೋ ಅಗೇನ್ December 6, 2010 ದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ 2.3 to 2.34 ಸೊ ಇಟ್ API ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ 9 to 10 ದ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ Ginger the bread. Next February 22, 2011 Android 3.0.x to 3.2.x to can be released and the API level is 11 to 13 and the name of the version is Honeycomb. And October 18, 2011 Android 4.0 to 4.0.3 the API level 14 to 15 the name of the version is Ice Cream Sandwich. July 9, 2012 the name of the version is Android 4.1 to 4.4 API level 16 to 18 the name of the version is Jelly Bean so these are the Android versions and release dates and API level again the version names of the Android next another one is release date is the October 31st, 2013 the version is the Android 4.4 to 4.4.4 the API level 19 to 20 the version name is KitKat so next October 17, 2014 Android 5.0 to 5.1 API level is 21 to 22 the name of the version is Lollipop October 5, 2015 the version name is 6.0 to 6.0.1 the API level 23 Marsh Molo the name of the version next October 22, 2016 Android version name is Android 7.0 to 7.12 API level is 24 to 25 Nugnut, the name of the version. Next, 21 August 2017, Android 8.0, the version. API level is 26. The name of the version name is Oreo. Next, October 6, 2018, Android version name is Android 9.0. API level 27. Version name is Pi. Next, September 3, 2019, Android 10.0. API level is 28. Next name of the version is Android Q. Next, recently October. September 8, 2020 the version is Android 11.0 API level is 29 so name of the Android name is the red violet cake so these are one of the Android the versions Next, what are the features of the Android programming? The Android has so many interesting features that makes it more powerful mobile operating system in the world. Few of them are the given below. So what are the features of Android programming? So the one is interface, user interface, connectivity, storage, messaging, multitasking. So first one is the user interface, which provides very beautiful to the user interface. Next, connectivity means Android supports various connectivity technologies like GSM, Edge, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, CDMA, etc. So these are the connective, so can be future. Another one is storage. SQLite is a very lightweight database which is used for the storage purpose in Android. So Android alli now storage purpose en madidara SQLite amma ondu storage lightweight database use madidhi ipatte storage purpose can be used in the Android. Next, messaging. It supports the SMS and MMS. So short messaging service and multiple messaging service can be introduced with one of the Android. Next, multitasking. Android supports multitasking features which lets you to learn the multiple applications simultaneously. So you know, multitasking mukantara now multiple feature now multiple application gal now simultaneously like nodabodu adu now multitasking anta now karuthe. So these are the features of the Android the programming. Next, Android interface. Ya tara Android interface iruthe andre the touch inputs, swiping, tapping and pinching, these are the touch inputs. Virtual the keyboard, the virtual keyboard, the immediate response after whenever vibration capabilities. The home screens are typically made up of the app icons and wide jets, and home screen is heavily customizable. Multiple screen support. At the top of the screen is a status bar which can be pulled down to reveal the notification screen. So these are the interface of the Android. Touch screen irutte amale virtual keyboard irutte amale the vibration capability irutte home screens are available. One of the app icons and widgets, home screens are really customizable. Multiple screen support irutte amale status bar screen next pull down whenever the notification screen. So this is one of the Android interface. Next, again continue the Android interface. Third party apps available on the Google Play Store, again other app stores can extensively retheme them the home screen. So again the music player can display the playback controls, and missed call notification provides the buttons for calling back and sending a caller to the caller and SMS music. These are the one of the Android interface. Next, Android hardware. So the main hardware platform of Android is 32-bit ARM V7 architecture. So the main hardware platform of Android is 32-bit ARM ARM V7 architecture. Again, also provides the support for the x86 architecture. For example, Google TV uses a special x86 version for the Android. Minimum requirements means at least 512 MB of RAM. Require 32-bit ARM V7 MIPS or x86 architecture processor, GPU and graphics processing unit with OpenGL ES 2.0 compatible. Android supports OpenGL ES 1.1, 2.0 and 3.0. So these are the requirements of the one of the Android hardware. Again, one of the another continue the Android hardware. Android can be also be run on 86 x86 by using Android emulator, which is an part of the Android SDK software development kit. Other emulators are BlueStacks or Andy. So these are emulators, and optional hardware components are still are video cameras, GPS, global positioning system, orientation sensors, dedicated gaming controls, accelerometers, gyroscopes, barometers, magnetometers, proximity sensors, pressure sensors, thermometers and touch sensors. These are the optional hardware components in the one of the Android. Next, what are the applications of the Android means? There are various categories of Android applications are as follows. One is entertainment, personalization, tools, communication, the productivity, media and video, music and audio, social, travel and local. So these are the applications. Entertainment, so TV, radio, music. So these are one of the entertainment can be used, and the personalization can be used on and tools, communication from one person to another person, the productivity, media and video, music, audio, social, travel, local. So these are the applications of the Android, the programming. Next, what are the advantages and disadvantages of the Android programming? Here, advantages means first one is Android is more customizable, can change almost anything. In Android, any new application can be done easily and without any review process. Use a different messaging app for SMS, easy access, cost effective, native integration with the Google Cloud storage. So these are the advantages of the Android. Disadvantage means the complex layouts and animations are harder to code in Android. Lot of process in the background that lead to an battery quickly drains. Low security and fake apps can be installed to steal your information from the unknown resources. And again, high device fragmentation. These are the one of the disadvantages. Means the complex layout and animation are harder to code the one of the Android one of the users. Lot of process background in the lead to battery quickly drains, means one of the more apps are running in the background, so that lead to one of the battery can be quickly the drains. Again, the low security and fake apps, so some of the person can be download the fake apps, so then your information can be stealed by the unknown persons or unknown resources. So another thing is that AI device fragmentation. So these are one of the disadvantages of the programming. So these are the Android devices in the market, one of the smartphones, the tablets, e-reader devices, netbooks, MP3, 4 players, internet, TVs, these are the Android devices available in the market. So here, these are one of the Android smartphones, again the tablets, these are the tablets, again the one of the desktop TVs, again, so these are the available in the market. So in this session we will discuss about the introduction of an Android programming, history of an Android programming, the features of an Android programming, Android interface, Android hardware, application of an Android programming, advantages and disadvantages of an Android programming. So we will see in the next session about the remaining the part of the Android programming in this level.